I have something I've been meaning to tell you. You see, I haven't been completely honest with you. I'm not a part of you. You're part of me. I created you. I'm the changing god.
What? The Specter's a changing god?
Why would I say no, I am? You said you were a thought, that I couldn't read you because you were like most things in here. A lie, he says, his outline flickering. I'm not just some reflection. I hid my thoughts from you. Now, I know this is a lot to take in. It means this body of yours is actually mine. I lived in it for years, and now that we know the first is still alive, I need it back.
And then what would happen to me?
A good question, he says. He seems taller than he did a moment before. Once you give me my body back, your thoughts would be pushed to the back of my mind. It would be frightening for a moment, disorienting maybe, but not painful. And then our thoughts would merge. You'd become a part of me again. He spreads his hands. And that's it. Now give me my body back.
No, this is my body, not yours.
I knew you'd say that. But let's get this straight. I lived in this body. I made it for a purpose. And now you say you're a wisp of a life outweighs my centuries of experience?
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Or maybe you think my first cast-off has a better way, Some magical solution to live out your false experience without price? I promise you she has no such thing. She has always only killed to get what she wants. Her self-interest is just as strong as yours and mine. The only difference between the three of us is that I am real.
Define real.
You wouldn't exist if it weren't for me. You don't exist apart from me. Everything you are is a byproduct of my skills, my intellect, my experiences. And now that I have a chance to stop the sorrow once and for all, you refuse me? Who in the hells are you?
The new owner of this body.
It was never yours to take, the Specter says, grimacing. No. Let me tell you what you are. You're an accident of fate, a parasite in the mind I built. See, now we have italics. You are a child. I don't want to destroy you, but I will if I must. Give me control.
Never.
Then I'll take it, the Specter says and spreads his arms.
Holy crap.
Not good. We can't fight the changing god now, what the hell? Tidal energy pours from the air around you, flowing into the Specter. The ground itself slips around your feet, holding you in place. You feel your grip on your body, your mind, slipping by finger lengths. You are diminishing. He is winning. You search your mind, your hard-earned memories, for something that will loosen his hold on you.
Wow, we have a lot of choices here.
Your machines of German women and Sega's mad, what makes you think you deserve to return?
Oh, he's not going to give a crap about that. I'm going to rip you out of my mind. We don't need to fight.
I found the Book of Singing Thorns and read the inscription. You've fallen far from when you began.
Maybe.
Summon the vision of the psychic warrior Leto showed you.
I don't even remember what that is.
Call upon the ghostly woman from the recesses of your mind. Pull your feet free, give up a collapse. Let's call upon the ghostly woman. Maybe she can help us. The moment your mind touches on her, she is there, facing the Specter, sorrow and anger radiating from her eyes, her heart. Scowling, the Specter flicks his hand to the side in a dismissive gesture, and she fades away once more, taking some of his radiance with her. His outline blurs, becoming hazier. Summon the vision of the psychic warrior that Leto showed me. Who's Leto? I didn't read about Leto in characters, I don't think. Struggling against the thunderous waves of the Specter's power, you struggle to remember the vision she showed you. But the pain, the noise, they bind you in screaming chains, holding you a hair width from the gift she gave you. No, says Leto, in your ear, and she says the word again, the noiseless word she once whispered to you. Her prophecy blossoms in your mind,
A shining silver web of lives and possibilities. Certainty fills you like armor. This moment is no accident. This is where you are meant to be. Across from you, the Specter flinches. He is nearly transparent now, nearly gone. I found the Book of Singing Thorns and read the inscription. You've fallen far from where you began. The Specter looks briefly surprised, and color bleeds from his flickering frame. He growls under his breath. I never forgotten what happened to her. Not once. With a shuddering gasp, he stumbles backwards, fading in and out of visibility. The pressure on your mind dwindles and ends. Fine, he says, eyeing you with cool contempt. If you're so intent on stopping the sorrow on your own, have at it. Let's see how you handle what's in store without my help, my guidance. Then he fades completely, but speaks again. His voice is coming from all around you, from every corner of your mind. He's not gone, only hidden himself in your mind. I've wasted my time trying to reason with you. That won't happen again. That's nice. Oh, we're loading again. Well, that was interesting. Gained 100 experience points. As the portal closes behind you, something feels off. It only takes a second to realize the Specter is gone. It is quieter now, in the calm of your mind. But he's not truly gone, is he? You can feel him out there, watching, waiting. Perhaps for a moment of weakness in which to strike. Great. Well, shall I level up then? Forward into the next level. Let's increase stat pool. Let's increase might. We have so little might. 1 point remaining. About 1-2 on might. I don't know what that whisper is. I can level up again? Okay. We'll increase edge. Hold on a second. I have edge in... And I have two edges. So I want an edge in intellect now. It's probably where I should have it because I use intellect most. Yes, you're whispering, echoing about something. Okay, so this, that goes to the dollar's fathom. Is that the dollar? Clock fathom? That's where I am, to the sorrow's fathom. Back to the ninth world. I'm just gonna save. I wanna... I guess that's the Sorrow's Fathom, right? I don't want to do that yet. Someone told me you have to be pretty high level to be doing that, so let's not do that just yet. Choi. Have I talked to Choi? Choi Kasul. The transparent form of a girl, Choi, you realize, huddles here, clutching herself. Her eyes are closed, her breathing slow and even. Other than the rise and fall of her small shoulders, she is utterly motionless. And that makes the sound she's making all the more audible. It is moaning, coming from the back of her throat, a low, guttural sound of fear and pain. The sound rises, surrounding you like an invisible electric force in the air, a chorus of 1,000 soft screams cut short. The hairs along your arms rise, sizzling. She looks at you in the eyes for the first time, and her shoulders relax ever so slightly. Her brow furrows as though she cannot remember where she recognizes you from. Almost too soft to hear, she whispers, "Thank you." The knuckles of her small hand tighten around her arms as you lean closer. How are you? She looks up at you and nods just slightly. How are you now? Although she is still huddled tightly, she looks up at you and nods. Are you alright? What happened to you? She holds herself tighter and shakes her head. Can you talk about what happened? She stares at her feet. Her head shakes just slightly. Alright, so... if I form a connection... you open your mind to hers, and icy terror pours into your mind, filling your veins, clutching at your throat. You breathe, forcing the foreign emotions away, and the physical symptoms subside, for now. The rigid line of choice shoulders relaxes a fraction of an inch. You appear to have taken some of her burden from her. So gain a new ability, Choi's Balm. Does that mean we severed the connection with the other? Let me see. Choi's Balm. Gain plus one training level in endurance skill, plus two might pool, plus one intellect pool. Nice. You have given Choi a piece of sorts. She returns the favor, helping you endure through difficult and painful times. So I still have this. Serias. Yeah, that's what I meant. Okay, so we can form connections with anyone in here, then. Cool. Cool. Does she talk now? I mean, maybe she can't talk because she was killed when she was like an infant. No, she's not gonna say anything. It's quieter here, she says. So there's Saria.
Yes.
So I have a connection with her as well. Oh, Inifir. Let's check in with Eritus first, and we'll talk to Inifir. Eritus's reflection gives you a shy smile. Hello, he says softly. Can't you think of any way we can get those demons out of you? I don't know, he says, sagging, but healers might, or doctors. So I'm guessing if we heal him, then we can form a connection with him as well. So here's Inifir, pretty awesome. I had no idea we'd find him in here. The pale image of Inifir regards you with empty, woe-worn eyes. It is an emptiness to drown in, a pit that can swallow whole all the empathy the heart can give without being filled even a bit. Like all voids, it beckons and seeks to drag you in. Inifir's emptiness drag you in? Is that forming a connection? I would speak with you, Inifir. Inifir shrugs a spectral shoulder. It is the lot of scamps to be picked, the mark of the weak to be pecked. Mind my vein, sister, with thy vain mind. How did you get here? You consume me, sister. Wherever my foul flesh festers, you've made a fouler feast of that which last passed death. That's one hell of a sentence. He sniffs and curls his face into a sneer. From one world of woe to another, sister. Have you found some comfort here? Inifir gives a grim laugh. Our father framed my flesh as a rack for pain, sister, and left no crook from which to hang a heartbeat's joy. Idly, I'd seek an ideal and know no peace, even in places better than this bitter warren. Then, just for a moment, his haggard features seem to soften. But there are worse holes to hide in, and worse homes than the head of she who felled me. How can I help you, Inifir? Unmake me, sister. Unwind time and tides, or break the causal chains that drag the present down to the past's black depths, or blot my tale from the scroll of days to come. Inifir curls his lips in a smile that is more a snarl. But you cannot, little sister. Even the changing god could not change a thing, and you are but his walking shadow. Is there no way that I can help you? None indeed, sister. Can you teach me how to open the gate? Never, sister. It's a lesson I would teach to none but the one who made us. Tell me something you learned in your years beyond the gate. Something flashes behind Inifir's eyes, a shadow of a shadow, but just as quickly, it is gone. Sister, all places teach the same woe. There are better things for you to study. come, tell me something you learned.
No, sister. Those are lessons not fit for words.
He really just doesn't want to tell us stuff.
Let Inifir's emptiness drag you in, but don't regret this. You allow Inifir to draw a part of you into his pain-hollowed heart, and in turn you take a part of his agony into yourself. In doing so, you feel yourself harden and grow stronger, though it is a strength that seems to twist inside you. Cool, so we got a new ability, Inifir's Madness.
Inifir's Madness.
Draw strength from madness, but pay a cost for that strength. Plus one might edge.
We got your three edges now in might.
Plus one training level intimidation skill. And minus one intellect pool.
I don't want minus one intellect.
Your brother's agony and power lives within you, crippling you, strengthening you.
The plus one might edge is like, I don't really care.
The minus one intellect I do not like. Plus one training and intimidation skill.
I might just keep it for that.
I mean, we still have a total of 19.
We still have 19?
I had 19.
Oh well. Figure I shouldn't have 19 anymore.
That's where I came from. This is back to the ninth world. Clock fathom, daughter's fathom.
Can I use the clock fathom? No, I can't. I wanted to see if I could use it to get back through the clock. No, there's only one way in or out of here.
Yes, now.
Yes, now. I wanted to see if I could use it to go through the clock back into Sega's Cliffs. But no, it's a one-way thing.
Ready. I'm going.
Let's check in with Saria. Nice high ceilings. There is no ceiling. Who are you? Saria, she says, rolling her eyes. Dead girl in the broken house. I know you have a lot on your mind, but come on. A reflection from Orseolo's mind, the only one that's left. So sad, some of these creatures are beings. Alright, back to the ninth world we go.
Alright.
Alrighty. Our calm is growing bigger and bigger, there's more and more people in it. Hope I don't get overcrowded in my own freaking mind. If that's possible. What the hell? Where are we? Oh, we're zooming around. That's not me. Oh, crap. Oh, we're in Miel Avest? The hell?
Your eyes snap open, and at first you feel you've fallen deeper into the labyrinth, another fathom. Flames rake the ground around you, the bedrock buckling under the heat. The image of Adiris resolves as your vision adjusts to the searing height.
My God, they're all fighting the sorrow. That's my fault. I led it here, didn't I?
Her composure is beginning to crack. You can see the fear in her eyes, held in check only by her iron will. You're awake. Quickly now. While you're inside the mirror, gods! The shields have fallen. The sorrow is breaking into the sanctuary. She scans the area. It's destroying our home. The others are trying to hold it back. But tell me first, did you find what you were looking for?
Um, yes and no. Mazov, all of this... All of these things. All the above. Yes and no. Mazov says the resonance... Well... Yeah, all the above, then. I found what I was looking for and much more. Where do I start? Would that we had time, but time is no longer our friend. She looks nervously at the flames around her, if it ever was. Now we must deal with the situation at hand. A few have already escaped, but most are trapped within the rubble and flames, some too terrified to move. You must get to the teleportation platform and flee. Save as many as you can on your way. Most are troubled beneath... These are weird flames. Most are trapped within the rubble and flames. Although the dome no longer encircles our sanctuary, the generators may hold enough power to slow the sorrow's progress. They can be activated by placing your palm here and whistling this tune. Her dry lips rasp a five-note descant that you commit to memory. She plants a kiss on your cheek. Good luck, sister. Let's make sure as many survive as possible. She runs off, her face raised in command, as if the quiet matron of Miel Avest had never existed. Cool. Evacuate to the teleport pad, extinguish fires with the shield generators, remove rubble to clear a path, save trapped cast-offs by removing obstacles or talking to them.
On my way.
A few weaker rocks lie cracked beneath below a larger group of boulders. If they could be removed, the rubble will collapse. Smash the smaller rocks to free the boulders. Oh, that's not enough. Damn it. The pile does not budge.
Action! Here I come!
Alright, let's do it better. A few of the rocks break free. The remaining cannot support the boulders above. The pile collapses and rolls out of your way. Well, that's so we can get to him, right? We're not afraid of you. Taste steel. Or miss. Oh, nice. So I can't interact with him. I can just run all the way up to him, I guess. And then end my turn.
Yes.
The sound's messed up when they speak. Out of range. Have her hide, I guess. Sorrow fragment, charge up and burst. Ooh, critical hit. Uh-oh. You know what? Oh, he's running over there. Oh, so we freed him. So... We didn't have to do what we did. Make your way out, brothers and sisters. The portal to the necropolis still functions. Alright. I had the wrong idea. Okay, we need to help these guys. See, that's like, I don't know, choppy. I am the very soul of action.
If you want a job done right.
And join a Sandhand's turn. Nice hit. It's damaged. I just need to make my way all the way over there.
On it.
Am I examining or interacting? Oh, cool. Nice. Talk to Adiris? Adiris' face is tense with worry as she surveys the destruction. Looking for where her efforts are most needed, she spares you a quick glance and says, "Make it quick. We need to evacuate as many as she can." Ask if she knows anything that might help rally the others. Ooh, we got a scorpion's desire. She hands over a cunningly crafted glass device. Take this. Use it, and it will lift their spirits and heal their bodies. Help our brothers and sisters. Target all in a small area around Caster. Heals 20 points of health and grants Scorpion's Desire to all characters, including enemies, in range. Plus 4 armor. Huh. I don't want that to do that to enemies. Consumes movement. Active entire crisis. A twisted pattern of purple and teal vapors is visible beneath the delicate surface of this homemade contraption. A crude inhaler rests on the top end, allowing the owner to consume the fumes, after which the inhaler snaps off, releasing the remaining vapors into an area around the user. The vapors heal a recipient's wounds and grants them temporary protection against attacks. It should be noted that the vapor can't distinguish between friend and foe, and affects all equally. The precise blend of materials and intriguing cosmetic oddities in this item are known to none but its maker. Alright. It's suppressed, I guess, so it's got a negative fettle. Okay, she's running for the path. Oh, she activated that. Cool. So how about a sucker punch? Down yet. I can't use it both on both of them. I'll just attack. Cool. So a fragment. These are all cast-offs. That's a Dearest. They're doing okay. Did we talk to Andronas? We're doing what we can. Leave us be. Ask them to help the other cast-offs. No? No? Alright. Because I don't have action points left. He nods curtly. Right. Let's go, Rima. Okay, they'll help the other cast-offs then. Alright. What else can we do? This thing leads you to doom. So I really don't mind a mess with that. We have this one stuck back here, I'm guessing. Let's interact with this thing next, then. Without a doubt. Elkishai. Just gonna activate the next one. Cool. This is pretty awesome. Oh, they're terrified. What's this happening? That looks pretty bad. What the hell is this? It's a person with tentacles. Abaddon's Abyss. We're done for. What is it? Well, that's the sorrow itself. Great.